been asked to do. Today in our Bible study, we were thinking about two mountains. One is Mount Sinai. It's the mountain that Moses brought the children of Israel to. When they were given the law there, Moses went up and got the Ten Commandments. It was a mountain that couldn't be touched by man or by beast. And only Moses could go. And we also talked about Mount Zion. It's the mountain that when David was made king for 2 Samuel 5, when David was made king in 2 Samuel chapter 5, he went to Jerusalem. But in Jerusalem, they rejected him. So he went to Zion and he built a city there called Bethlehem. It's the city of David. And it's also the city where Christ was born. Christ was born in Zion. So I want to read out of Hebrews 12, starting in verse 18. For ye are not come unto the mount that might be touched, and that burned with fire, nor into blackness and darkness and tempest. And this is a description of Mount Sinai. And the sound of a trumpet, and the voice of words, which voice they that heard entreated that the word should not be spoken to them anymore. For they could not endure that which was commanded. And if so much as a beast touched the mountain, it shall be stoned, or thrust through with a dart. And so terrible was the sight that Moses said, I exceedingly fear the quake. But ye are come unto Mount Sinai, and unto the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, and to an innumerable company of angels. To the general assembly and church of the firstborn, which are written in heaven, and to God the judge of all, and to the spirits of just men made perfect, and to Jesus the mediator of the new covenant, and to the blood of sprinkling that speaketh better things than that of Abel. And I think for every believer, we have a decision of which mountain will I live at, which mountain will I go to. Which mountain will I put my faith in? Mount Sinai, the mountain of the law that I can't live up to. It's like a terrible mountain. I was reading Exodus 19 yesterday, and I was like kind of depressed. I mean, it's kind of a sad story altogether. The people are just failing. Moses is up there with the law. He leaves them rules, and they just fail. Make an idol and worship it and run around naked. It's like just like this depressing story. But Mount Zion is a story of David. And where the mountain he ran to was a mountain of refuge. In Isaiah says that God is going to put the cornerstone on Mount Zion. Christ is born in Mount Zion. Mount Zion, as far as I can see, it could be the most geographically praised place in the Bible. I could be wrong about that, but there's a lot of verses on Zion. I was in my concordance yesterday. I read a number of them, but I couldn't read them all. It was like a zillion of them. I don't know if there's a zillion verses in the Bible, period. There's a lot of them. And I think, what's our purpose in life? To live in Sinai or Zion? What kingdom are we in? The kingdom of the law? The law is perfect. But that's not what saved us. We're in the kingdom of God. And Zion is the mountain we run to. It's the mountain of grace. It's the mountain of love. It's the mountain where our Savior was born. And it's where the heavenly Jerusalem will be. In verse 28, wherefore we receiving a kingdom which cannot be moved, let us have grace whereby we may serve God acceptably with reverence and God. that's the kingdom we're in. And if we're in that kingdom, it can't be moved. We also can't be moved. Experientially, yes, but we cannot be moved.
On Mount Zion. So our purpose in life, I think, is to run to Mount Zion.
Lord, please bless our day today. Give us extra receptivity now. Roger's message. Bless him. Jesus' name.
Just intercede for us and all that we care so much about. us of our own confusion and selfishness. We really ask that these things, as we grow as young people, as young men and women, that we would find our place in your purpose. That's what we see, Lord. That identity in your plan, your perfect plan. We want nothing less. We don't want any leftovers. We don't want the seconds of anything. We want straight from you. We want to be real in that way. We just thank you. And thank you so much for Pastor Ryan. Thank you so much for this faithful man, this church. In Jesus' name. I also want to show you, I have a postcard here from Kunming, China. This is a Finnish girl. It's like one of my best friends, you could say. And I went to Bible school with her for 4 years in Bible school. And she just wrote me a card that I got from one of our Bible college students that visited her. And it's just so amazing, like, what happens when you follow God and you get a friend like this. It's just in the middle of China, just looking for, just witnessing people and learning Chinese. Like you should see, half of it's just in Chinese lighting. I mean, it's not so confusing to you because you guys have similar languages. But just for me, it's just so amazing. And she's so smart. She knows. She gives me the one with the random street. It's like, you know, chickens hanging in the corner and like little nomads. It's like little shacks and like thatched roofs. It's so cool. It's really exciting, actually. I see it. I just want to go somewhere. And I was just thinking, you know, our purpose is only found in Christ, you know. And I share this with the young people, and I have another message that I kind of want to talk to you about, but I think still this is it. And I want to just paint two contrasts, and that is man's plan versus God's purpose. And really, I wouldn't want to say that man has a purpose, because it's kind of unfair for man. I don't think man is that smart. You know, I don't think we're actually that good that we have a purpose, because our purpose is only found in Christ. So I don't want to give man too much credit. It's kind of like saying the flesh is something. It's really not anything more than sinful. You know what I mean? Man's plan versus God's purpose. And I was thinking, you know, with the young people, you know, I told them all, it's like, when I see them, it's like you see a question mark on their face, you know. Just, like, each little Korean girl, it's like, wow, big question mark. Because I remember being, you know, we all did, like, really young, and that we walked around kind of questioning everything. You know, questioning what our mom said to us, you know, questioning what the teacher said, and this and that. And then we kind of, like, generated ourselves, or, you know, moved on with whatever. But we still had that question. I think as church believers, like young people, we lose our way in this. And that has to do with our identity. And that's all I want to talk about that. You know, man has a plan that's born of himself. But God has a purpose that is found in him. And if I could answer that question, I would simply say, if I want to know my purpose, I have to find God's. It's just as simple as that. If I want to know my purpose in life, I have to look at God's. Because really in ourselves, man's plan is to satisfy himself. And I want you to read it. It's in Ecclesiastes chapter 6. I asked one of the young people, I was like, how do you say Ecclesiastes in Korean? Like, no one knew it. What is Ecclesiastes in Korean? How do you say it? Ecclesiastes.
Hi.